Hello, y'all. It's Brett, the Swafford Homestead, or be called Swampy. We've had over 4 inches of rain this week. Yeah, it's made a mess. I thought I'd do a little garden walk around if I can get close enough to show you some of it. Starting here and here, them two. That's cauliflower and broccoli. Ones I planted first. There's my first row of tomatoes. We made a video about planting them early. They looking really good. I'm standing next to a couple of raised beds. Let me go ahead and cover them while I'm standing here since I'm in the way of them. My lettuce bed, of course. I planted lettuce and you can see where most of it's went. It washed up against this wall. We don't get light rains hardly anymore. We get downpours or almost like a cloud burst the other night. Washed the garden, washed everything. My garlic, yeah, it needs weeding. I've got some stalky thing growing in it that I got, I'm assuming, out of the dirt because it's taking over. But the garlic is getting closer. I think June is when it comes to you. We haven't got a stem just yet coming up. A few plants I'm working on, blackberries. I'm always trying to get a few extra blackberries going. Got some cuttings going there. I'm hoping that's mighty musky dying cutting up. But anyway, I know I rambled, but we're back on target. These was Mule Team tomatoes. First row I put out. That's ones I did the video also with the war and the electric culture, and you know, we'll leave that alone. This is Mule Team and Early Girl tomatoes. Walk down through here, maybe, if I don't sink. I got four jalapenos at the end. There's 21 tomatoes in the Mule Team. There's 21 in this row of mix of Mule Team and Early Girl, and I am sinking. let's see. Cucumbers. That's that row of crooked cucumbers I put out. They're growing every which direction now. That is cantaloupe, and I'm going to have to see if I can back out of here because I'm getting deeper. It's a little mucky. See if I can back up. I'll show you what's going on here. Yeah, I'm sinking bad. More jalapenos. There's four right there. This is Jet Setter. I mix them together because they really ain't much difference. You buy them in separate packs, but they're about 3 or 5 days different, maybe. Reads basically the same way, just a few days different on the germination same. Row number three, Jet Star, Jet Setter, has got 20. This row's Jet Star and Jet Setter, it has 20. And I guess I'll just hold the camera up and tell you there is four jalapenos at the end of this row. That's 12 jalapeno plants. That's 84 tomato plants. Roughly 25, I think, of the broccoli, 25 of the cauliflower. Maybe, no, there's 30. I think there's 30 of each. Nothing here. This is what happens when it rains and you live in heavy clay soil. It was tilled just the other day. It's almost green with grass and weeds and turnip greens. Turnip greens don't never die. They might die back, but they don't die. You sit there. It's good cover crop. This I'm kind of excited about. I've got 6 rows of bodacious sweet corn. And it didn't wash. Well, that reminds me. I missed something. Let me step back. I forgot all about this. They just now coming up. That little green stuff there, is my okra. Well, till you see that bad spot about right there, from that bad spot down about 3 feet, there is nothing growing, and it starts again. What was in that bad spot is now way down there, but it's growing. I thought, well, I'll dig it up and I'll bring it back. At least it's growing. Seeds was good. 4 inches of rain moves things. 4.5, somewhere in there. Expecting more. That's when we're out now. Jumbled up video, I know. Let's see, zucchini and squash. I think zucchini's first. I got them down through there, and that was a nice bug that just crawled across the screen. See if we can find our way around the garden without sinking again. No, I can't get no gardening work done. Everything's muddy and mucky. I got a few more things down here, and then we'll have to travel to the other gardens. I'm trying to make this fairly quick, but also tell you what's here. This row of fence wire has got snap peas on it, sugar snap peas. They're blooming. I've got a couple small peas in there. But the soil really hadn't got warm to this week. When it started raining heavy, the soil temperature come up and everything took off. It has to get mid to upper 60s before things really start growing. And this was something I was not expecting to grow back the way it did. This is my sunchokes. I read the instructions several times. I've studied over the sunchokes before I planted them. I know they're invasive, but it said if you had to remove every piece of the root to keep them coming back. I got down on my hands and knees and went through this dirt and sifted it basically with my fingers, looking for any little parts and pieces because I wanted to control it. Well, apparently the tiniest of pieces that you don't even see grows better than the original sun roots that I put in here, sunchokes. Ones I bought didn't grow this good. So when they come back for the first time, they do really well. And the way it looks, I'm probably gonna have a lot more. If I can thin them out a little bit, it'd be good. If not, we have sunchokes. We have Jerusalem artichokes, as some people call them. And I'm sinking again, so we're gonna have to move to the other garden. I'm tired of the suction sound on my shoes. I shouldn't sink in yet, but my blackberries, goji berry, lycopene berry, tree there, muscadine vine, wild grapevine all together, gazebo. Time to move. I gotta get out of this. Ready? Back to gardening. Raspberries. I had to think. I got so much stuff growing around here. That's a sweet cherry. Plum. Hardy banana. More different kinds of plums. Pay no attention to the growed up raised bed I haven't got worked over yet. Down this trellis is pole beans. I went back with the Mountaineer Half Runner beans because they are drought tolerant. They can handle the drought a lot better than the Kentucky Wonders did. I used to have good luck with these. I planted them several times, but hopefully they'll do really good this year too. I got them on, of course, on this side, and I've got them on this side. Yeah, they some grass coming back out. It's always grass once it starts raining. Got my onions. No, these weren't the onions I planted back in the fall. I planted some long day heirloom ones I could save seed off of. And all the crazy weather and storms that we got literally beat them to death. I don't think I saved 4 out of 150-200 onions. I had to replant these. I just planted onion bulbs. This is why I'd have onions. But the weather's been pretty hard on these. You can tell they're beat up pretty bad. They ain't nowhere close to being mature, and they are, the leaves and stuff's already beat down on them. We'll get onions one way or the other. Might not be the biggest and the prettiest, but they'll be onions. Well, let's see. Let's go to the third garden. Well, we're about there. A little bit of a walk. It's on the other end of the property. Garden number three. That is broccoli and cauliflower and kind of mixed. One's on one end, one's on the other. I can't tell you which one's which now. They've done grown too long. These are contender bush beans. Got three nice rolls. See the water holes. Okay, here's the potatoes again. See if I can remember how this goes. This row, this one was the first. It was in the third week of March. Nice colored. Now this row, this one, and this one was around the 1st of April. I'd have to look the dates up. Close. These last four rows was 2nd week of April, end of the 2nd week, somewhere in there. There's about 2 weeks between them, no matter how it worked out. I roughly planted them about 2 weeks apart. So I've got them succession planted, so I don't have to dig necessarily all of them at one time. The potatoes are doing really good. Went through several frosts, but they made it. The frost didn't get to the ground. The frost stayed up 3 or 4 feet off the ground, roughly. I'm going by the hood of a truck. Well, that's the lowest place I spotted frost, but anyway. Can't walk out in it, but that's 15 sweet potato plants. There's 15 there. I've got room for the rest of them. I should have about 17 more to put on each side, I think. And this is trying to be, with all the water, and it's 6 rolls of Bodacious sweet corn again. I bought a big bag and I decided I was planting it all. I wasn't gonna save any. And it's doing all right for something that's washed as bad as this is. This had nice ridges. You could tell I'd run a tiller on it. It was all crumbly and ready to plant, and yeah, it's all down here now. I'll walk around the other side, maybe we can spot it. Get over here close to the corn. They're just coming up. Right across there should be sorghum. Should be a row right here. Row here. It's washed pretty bad, but it's there. Should have been a row here, but I don't see much of it. There's part of a row left there. I don't know what I'm going to get out of this, if I get anything, but if it'll dry up the next few days, I'll fix it. If it don't dry up for another week or two, I ain't going to worry about it. We'll use whatever we got. You can see the corn. Probably should have started out over here. You can see the ditches it washed. I mean, that's my sweet potatoes. They haven't been on the ridge, they've been gone. And there were no deep ridges like that until it rained, but you can see how bad it cut it. Another reason why I plant potatoes on ridges. These potatoes are doing good, the water's staying drained off. They're nice and tall. Can I walk out? I want to get a height for now. You can see I got greens still growing. They're knee high. That's about right. Water, water everywhere. A few potatoes that didn't do well, but some of them's a little late. Most of them's done really well. And tender beans again. The other end of the broccoli and cauliflower. That's pretty much what I got plenty of. We didn't go over fruit trees or strawberries and all that stuff, but I planted 50 strawberry plants the other day, which I didn't make a video. It was in between rainstorms. We run out and do things. I run out and do things. Miss Cindy ain't been able to help me lately. But you got the gist of what we got planting. It's been a hard road to hold with all this rain, but we've got something growing. Y'all have a good day.